Being put into prison is a life-altering event. It is the price one pays for doing something wrong to other people. Justice is served, as the cliché goes. Unfortunately, however, many innocent people are put away behind bars every year. Some of them for just a short period of time, but some of them are sadly given life sentences for crimes they haven't committed. We rounded up a list of 10 people found not guilty after serving life sentences. Many of them served their terms for more than 4 decades, bearing the burdens of the sins done by the real murderers and evildoers. When the day of reckoning came, the people on our list were found not guilty. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more awesome content, and click on the notification bell so you know when we publish new videos. Let's dive right in. Number 10. John Nolley. In 1996, John Nolley, who lived in the state of Texas, was convicted for the murder of his friend Sharon McLean. The only evidence against him was the testimony of 3 informants who said that they heard Nolley making incriminating statements against McLean. He was sentenced to life imprisonment at the age of 44. During the reinvestigation, new evidence was uncovered, proving that the witnesses gave perjured testimony during the case trial. Their credibility was questioned. In addition to the new development, a bloody palm print found at the scene of the crime was analyzed through new technology. It wasn't Nolley's. After 21 years in prison, John was fully exonerated on the charges brought against him and was released in 2016. His case prompted the Texas legislators to pass a law that regulates the use of the testimony of jailhouse informants. As for John, he married his childhood friend and is now the proud father of John Nolley III and 2 his other adult children. He has a lawn service business and is now living a happy life. Number 9. Eric Kelley. Eric Kelley was wrongfully convicted of murder alongside Ralph Lee. The two were accused of staging the 1993 robbery and murder of Tito Marino in New Jersey. They were sentenced to life in prison due to inconsistent and contradictory confessions that they made during the police interrogation. At the time, however, Eric was suffering from a cognitive impairment because of a brain injury. The condition made him more susceptible to giving false statements under stressful situations or pressure. After several years, a hat left at the crime scene was approved to go through DNA testing. It led to the identification of another perpetrator, thus proving the innocence of the two men. However, prosecutors denied the request to investigate the new suspect and fought against their release. After many lengthy appeals, the charges were dropped in April 2008, finally absolving them for the crimes they never committed 24 years beforehand. Eric is now working at a hotel in Manhattan and living in his own apartment. Number 8. Johnny Edward Tallbear. Based on the statement made by a witness claiming that one of the men who beat and stabbed a homeless man recited an Indian chant, Johnny Tallbear of Oklahoma, a member of the Iowa tribe, was falsely convicted of murder in 1992. The witness was 100 yards away when the crime happened, but said that he was certain it was Tallbear. At the time, Johnny was physically incapable of committing the crime because he was confined in his wheelchair. But the strong testimony of the witness led to a life sentence. Thanks to DNA testing and blood samples that failed to match Tallbear's during the reinvestigation of his case, the prosecutors eventually dismissed the charges, making him a free man after 26 years in prison. Right after his release, he ate his favorite brisket taco at a downtown restaurant. Number 7. Stephen Phillips. A series of violent crimes in Texas in 1982 sent Stephen Phillips to prison, all because of the descriptions that the victims gave to the police. The statements were all identical and were that the perpetrator had striking blue eyes, wore a hooded gray sweatshirt, and had a piece of cloth on the lower part of his face. For more than 25 years, Phillips served his term until his case was accepted by the Innocence Project. The subsequent DNA testing proved that he was innocent of the alleged crimes. In August 2008, all charges against him were dropped and made official through the writ of habeas corpus on October 1, 2008. To compensate him for his time in prison, the state of Texas paid him a $2 million lump sum and $11,000 monthly annuity. Number 6. Lawrence McKinney. At the young age of 22, Lawrence McKinney of Tennessee was sentenced to 115 years in prison for first-degree burglary and assault of a woman. The victim identified him as one of her 2 attackers that committed the crimes in 1978. In 2008, McKinney requested a DNA testing of the biological stains from the victim's linens found on the scene to prove his innocence. The results proved that he was not there when it happened. He was finally released on July 20, 2009, after serving 31 years and 9 months behind bars and received only a $75 compensation award. He fought to be fully exonerated so that he could apply for due compensation. He was awarded a total of $1 million to be paid in monthly installments over 10 years. Number 5. Malcolm Alexander. Malcolm Alexander was 21 years old and the young father of a 2-year-old child when he was accused of assaulting a woman in Louisiana. His attorney neglected to present an opening statement and cross-examine the witnesses, making the defense weak and ineffective. For 38 years, he endured life inside prison, all while hoping for his eventual exoneration. His wish was granted when the result of a DNA test proved that he was innocent. The grounds that falsely convicted Alexander were found to be deeply flawed due to an unreliable identification procedure. Moreover, a lot of evidence at the crime scene was destroyed after the trial. His lawyer was subsequently disbarred. Upon his release, his son Malcolm and his grandson Malcolm were there to welcome him along with the mother of his son. Joining the family was Innocence, a puppy Malcolm adopted while in prison. Number 4. Craig Kelley. In 1978, Craig Kelley, a Vietnam War veteran from California, was arrested for murdering his partner Rhonda Wicht and her 4-year-old son. Rhonda was assaulted and strangled to death while her son was suffocated. A neighbor told the investigators that she heard a commotion in the apartment and then saw Kelley and his truck, making him the prime suspect. He denied the accusation and consistently claimed he was innocent even after he was sentenced to life without parole for double murder charges. DNA evidence absolved Kelley during the review of his case. He was finally released in November 2017 after 39 years in prison. He was awarded $21 million in compensation by the Simi Valley City. Number 3. Wilbert Jones. If you think that 30 years of confinement is torturous, the next man on our list served 45 years and 10 months plus 1 day before he was exonerated in August 2018. Wilbert Jones was arrested during the period of racial tension in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, for the kidnapping and violent assault of a nurse. In 1973, he was deemed guilty of the charges and was sentenced to life in prison, despite the statements of the victim that she was not really sure of his identification. Illiterate, poor, and no one to help him in the legal battle, his only hope was a miracle. The Innocence Project of New Orleans took his case and discovered new evidence about a serial violator that accurately matched the description made by the nurse. On November 15, 2017, Jones was released on bail and reunited with his family until his eventual full exoneration in 2018. Number 2. Richard Phillips. He spent 45 years and 2 months in his cell, bearing the weight of a crime that he'd never even thought of doing. He sang, wrote poetry, painted, and planned to kill the person who framed him. Richard Phillips was convicted in 1972 with a life sentence for conspiracy and first-degree murder of Gregory Harris in Detroit, Michigan. He was implicated as a conspirator by Fred Mitchell, the man's brother-in-law. After long battles of failed motions, his hope was reignited when the Michigan Innocence Clinic took his case and presented the sworn testimony of his co-accused and a polygraph test result. Finally, on December 2, 2017, Phillips was granted freedom. To compensate for his wrongful conviction, the state of Michigan awarded him $1.5 million in May of 2019. He never did take revenge on Mitchell because he realized that he was not a cold-blooded murderer. Mitchell, however, drank himself to death at the age of 49. Number 1. Albert Woodfox. Spending 43 years in prison is no joke, especially when you are an isolated prisoner since day one. This is the case of Albert Woodfox, who was falsely convicted along with another inmate for murdering prison guard Brent Wallace of the Louisiana State Penitentiary. The only pieces of evidence against them was a crime scene fingerprint and the testimonies of 3 inmates. He appealed his case 3 times, but each time the Louisiana officials would conduct a retrial. What is highly controversial about this case was the fact that he was held in solitary confinement in a 6x9-foot prison cell. He was there 23 hours a day. The remaining hour was for his exercise time outside the cell. He was all alone and kept shackled. Eventually, the time was reduced to 3 hours a week. In 2016, after a court ruling, Woodfox was released and became a free man. There it goes, our list of the top 10 people found not guilty after serving life sentences. Did we miss anyone? Let us know in the comments below. Share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more amazing top 10 lists. See you next time!